Good Monday evening to you all. So the New York Times asked a question in an opinion headline recently. It was this: why is raising a kid in the United States so hard? Not the parenting highs and lows of it, but the cost of it, specifically in this country. The president and Congress are haggling right now over that issue, among others, in President Biden's big spending plan. And while they do that, we visit the issue that is at the heart of so many decisions about life and work right now for working families.
To have a baby or not, that is the question. Well, it may be more like, can we afford to leave work to have a baby right now or not, is the more accurate version of that question. So today I sat down with an Axios reporter who put together a list of Minnesota companies who offers what in terms of parental leaves.
Let's start from a wider perspective. Globally, the U.S. is simply dismal, to say the least, when it comes to childcare. This chart, according to the New York Times, shows how much governments spend on childcare for toddlers. Norway leads at $29,726 per child each year. Germany, middle of the pack at $18,656. Australia, on the lower end at $8,088. And the U.S. is dead last in the world in what it contributes to American families at $500 per year. The good news is that there is a part of it that sets cash aside for paid family and medical leave. But the bad news is that there's this other dismal chart from the Pew Research Center. That's Estonia leading the pack with 86 weeks of government-mandated paid leave for new parents. And you guessed it, that's U.S. in the bottom with 0 weeks of mandated paid leave.
Compared to like first world or industrialized countries, like, yes, we do not mandate it. Employers do not have to give any. They have to guarantee that you get your job back once 12 weeks is up, but that doesn't mean they have to pay you to be gone.
So private sectors have stepped up. Sort of. Nick Halter, a reporter at Axios, compiled a compelling list of Minnesota companies and what their paid parental leave policies are like.
What you generally will find is these big Fortune 500 companies offer some pretty good health care plans because they have the means to do so. And on top of that, they have the reason to do so because they're in a fight for talent right now.
And the fight is a good one. According to Nick's report, General Mills came in at the top with full paid time off for new birth mothers for 18 to 20 weeks. 3M also offers 20 weeks, but with only 10 weeks paid. Ameriprise, Medtronic, and Wells Fargo offer up to 16 weeks. Companies like United Natural Foods, Inc. sit on the lower end at 4 weeks paid maternity leave, and folks at Allina Health get 2 weeks of paid time off each year as caregivers.
What's crazy about that is General Mills offers, like someone like me who would be a father, more than a lot of companies offer a mother. In fact, way more than most companies would offer the mother. Just for some perspective, only about 20% of employees in the U.S. actually get paid parental leave.
I think it's just kind of ridiculous to give birth to this human being and then go to work 2 weeks later. If you broke your leg and you had like open knee surgery, going back to work 2 weeks later is also still very hard.
Yeah, and that's what like a mother or, you know, parents have to confront, is that like you can take 12 weeks, but you won't get paid for those 12 weeks. And if you don't make a lot of money, like that's a difficult thing.
The other thing that Nick mentioned that he says he wished he included in his article was, what would the career advice be for prospective job seekers who might be looking to have children in the near future or the future? Should they ask their employer about paid parental leave policies? Would that be a difficult thing to ask, given that they're nervous that they won't be maybe offered a job if they're going to be pregnant in the near future? So bottom line is, it's tough, Jana.
Yes, it absolutely is. But it's a lot of information for folks that they're looking for about companies in Minnesota. Thanks so much, Sharon.